My name is Maria Afzal, and I completed my engineering in information technology from Hindustan College of Science and Technology in the year 2014. And in one of the opportunities that I got as a pool campus drive, I got selected in Cognizant Technology Solution as a campus placement. I started my journey as a trainee in Cognizant, and for like almost 5 years, I was with them. With Cognizant, I got an opportunity to move to on-site, and after working with them for almost 5.5 years, I have recently switched to Fiserv of Ireland. Most of my expertise lies in banking and financial sector. So yeah, currently I'm on a role of a senior test analyst with Fiserv. That's it.
That's really great to hear, ma'am. And congratulations for your tremendous growth in these past years.
Thank you.
So ma'am, how was your transition from a college fun life to a professional background?
Okay, so like there's a lot of what you say, aspiration, like people are apprehensive from moving to college life to a corporate life. Yes, the transition is not seamless because in college you are in a very secured environment. If you do any mistakes, there's people will point at you, but they won't like make fun of you, or they won't be like, you won't get judged because you have your friends, you have your faculty. But when you are in a corporate world, you have to be a little apprehensive and a little like mindful of the things that you are doing. Like, it starts with your training period. So when you are in a training period, there will be a lot of people who are sailing in the same boat because they all have just come out from the college. They are still trying to figure out what to do in a corporate world. But it is actually there where you put your all the college information and whatever you have learned from your books into practical knowledge. And one thing leads to another, and eventually it will all be okay. Yes, in the beginning it is like little, your boat will be little rock, but eventually it will be okay. You will learn from your mistakes, you will learn from your seniors, they will be there to guide you. Not everyone is very tight, they will be helpful. And from moment to moment, you will have to learn, and you will have to continue keep that graph growing. Like, you cannot say that if I have, your learning does not stop after college. If you are a part of one project, you will move to another project, and you will have to always keep up with the latest market trends. So continuous learning always.
Yes, ma'am, that's very true. Learning never ends.
Learning never ends, yeah.
So ma'am, my next question is, what fears did you overcome to build yourself into a better professional?
Okay, so this one starts with my previous like answer that I gave. When you have to move to a corporate world, there is a slight fear that how are you going to adjust in that particular corporate sector without your friends, your families. The change is a real big one because now you are a part of something, a market you start to own, you start have your own responsibilities. You have to move out from your family, or if you are staying with your friends, whatever, then you have to go embrace your new responsibilities, take up the new challenges. So if that's actually the learning phase of your life. So I had that fear whether I'll be able to make it, I'll be able to live away from my family for so long. But yes, you have to adapt, and that's how you grow.
That's very true, ma'am. So ma'am, what is the work of a senior test analyst, and how has your growth rate in this company and the previous company been?
Okay, so I'll start from the beginning. So like I mentioned, I joined Cognizant as a trainee. So my domain was testing. I was always in testing. I began as a tester with Cognizant, where I was given a full training of the automation as well as the manual tests that we conduct. And my major expertise lies in banking and financial sector. So I have worked with the major US, UK and Irish banks, where I personally worked on their applications, their day-to-day banking activities that everyone does or everyone uses. Maybe it is mobile app or the desktop applications, internal maybe to the bank or client-facing. So I've worked on a variety of banking domains. Then with Fiserv, like I have switched almost like 7 or 8 months back. So here my role is a little different. I'm not working directly with the clients, but I am working on the actual payment gateways and cards, be it a Visa card or a MasterCard. So I work on the actual cards and how the payment industry and day-to-day transaction flows. So basically how the money moves, I work on that. Yeah.
That's a lot of work to hear, ma'am. And I know that's really tough to do as well. So, ma'am,
every penny counts.
What are your views about? Yes, ma'am. So, ma'am, what about your views of in college life? Is it necessary to get various exposures during your college life?
Yes, I think it's very important that you are exposed to all the fields in your college life. You don't have to just be a bookworm. And like I have seen people just working on their academics, they totally ignore the importance of maybe your interpersonal skills or the summer trainings that you have or the internships that you go to. So I think it's an overall package. You have to, it's just not like that if you excel in your academics, you'll excel in everything too. No, you have to take everything together, participate in sports, be it cultural activities, be it your summer training. I think overall how you interact with people, how you put your knowledge to the actual application, that's how it matters. So exposure to all the fields is really important according to me.
So ma'am, like we have heard that in corporate life or in professional life, you have to put on a mask before everyone else. So is it true?
No, not for me at least. I don't think you have to put on a mask, but yes, you have to be a little mindful. Like you put a filter in between. You cannot say anything that's coming in your mind, or you cannot just be as if they are your friends. Yes, you will make some good friends in your colleagues, but first they are your colleagues, and then you are working in a corporate world. They will be seniors. They will be people who are there from like 10 or 15 years. You cannot just be doing silly stuff there. You have to be a little more mindful how you are conducting, where your surroundings are. Sometimes you will be in a client location, so you have to be very careful, like you don't do anything stupid that impacts your work or maybe your company in general. So you have to be yourself, but just a little bit more poised and mindful of where you are. Not necessarily a mask, but it's in a way, so, it's a good learning for you. Yeah.
So basically, mask isn't necessary. It's your maturity level that counts there.
Yes, how you handle things, how you speak to others, your juniors, your seniors. So yeah, more or less like college, but just a little more refined.
Yes, ma'am. So ma'am, now coming back to your college days. So is it so that you still recall your college days? And if so, then what one moment is still there in your mind that you cherish every day?
Always, like college life, I think I cannot stress enough on the fact that how important a college life is. I was very lucky enough to have been mentored by some great faculties and the HOD, especially Shankar sir, and we are still in touch with most of the faculties who have taught me. But the most important part has to be the hostel life. There you make friends for your lifetime. They become your confidants over the time. So hostel life, yes, we do cherish the food that we used to hate so much, but then eventually we try to adapt to that food, just going out to campaigns, doing silly stuff together in college, participating in the cultural activities, the sports and everything. So it, for me, it was not only about academics, it was a lot of experience that I had in college. Like I participated in a lot of cultural activities as well. So yeah. And the activities that you do in college, like not exactly those, but the experience that you gain them. Maybe if you are organizing some event in college, probably when you move to a corporate world, there are similar events that happens, or maybe you have to organize something, or you just put your that experience into college. So I think college fun, the hostel life, that's the part I miss the most.
That's really good to hear.
Yeah.
I would like to know who your inspiration and what one quality makes him or her your inspiration?
So this one for me has to be my mother. I won't go into like too much of inspirational things, because I believe in like real time things that I have seen, and I have seen my mother working from a very, when I was a very young kid. So I've seen how beautifully she handled her work and the kids. Like I have a younger brother. So she used to handle the work and her personal life really well. So I aspire to be her someday without complaining, without judging. She just used to excel in both her careers. So I aspire to be her someday.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, that answer is absolutely perfect, because every mother, like we, all of us have learned from our mothers. Ma'am, That's really true, ma'am. That we everything that we have learned far is from our mothers only. Since childhood only, we have got all the values and all the manners from our mothers. So yeah, they are surely our first inspiration. So ma'am, like how often do you visit your parents? Because since you are far away from your country, so is it difficult for you to visit your parents? And what feeling is it when you visit them?
Yeah, that's a very tough question because yes, you are homesick when you're away from family. Initially, when I moved here, I tried to visit them at least on major festivals and every 6 months. But as we all know, the situation has been very different from there since last year, like with COVID and all the travel restrictions and all. So this year, January, I visited them after 18 months and that was really difficult for me. But yes, you have your community here, you have your friends here, so they are there to help you. But when you go home, obviously, it's a altogether different feeling. You will get pampered a lot. And it's family, friends, and especially the food is that you crave for when you are away from home. So I make sure when I go home, I have all those experiences. I eat whatever I like, meet all my friends, my family, just spend some quality time together and make new memories and come back with them. Yeah.
That's really sweet. Yeah. From my friend, the last thing that I want to ask is that is there any piece of advice that you would like to give to your juniors so that they may build their career in a better way?
Yes, from what I learned from my experience from college and in the corporate world, focus on what real life examples you can have, what all experiences you can share. So take everything into account and just put that knowledge that you have for your personal growth. Don't just rely on books, like not on the academics too much. Focus on your trainings, your internships, because it's there where you'll actually learn your bookish knowledge. You'll put it into good use. Participate in the cultural activities. Be outgoing. That's what I'll suggest. Because in the end, it's not like who came first, who came last. It's your overall journey. And trust me on the fact, like some years down the line, you are going to miss your college life. So don't take it too seriously. Just enjoy, go with the flow. There will be failures. There will be good times. Embrace your mistakes. Learn from them. Do not repeat your mistakes again and again. Just learn from them and move on. So basically just go easy, chill. Do not stress too much.
I think that's the best piece of advice that any student could ask for. Because generally it happens that societal pressure makes the students believe that it's the marks that matters in the long run. But since you've told and a lot of seniors also tell us that's not true.
Yes, and have a lot of hands-on experience, I would say. Take your labs very seriously. Because here nobody is going to ask you write a program on a page. They are actually going to ask you to do it on your laptop. So yes. Gain knowledge and try to put it in good use.
Thank you, ma'am, for this great piece of advice. And thank you for joining us. It was great talking to you and knowing about you and knowing how you work and how the professional life works. So thank you so much, ma'am, for giving us your time.